It's a big night at the banks of the Brazos. Is this Baylor's moment to seize, to storm into true playoff contention? Undefeated, unrespected by many, with a point to prove. It's the Bears against the standard bearers in the Big 12. Oklahoma swaggers into Waco, also chasing a playoff bid with a new star quarterback trying to keep a stranglehold on the status quo. A showdown in Texas tonight. Big 12 collision between the Oklahoma Sooners and the undefeated Baylor Bears. Is Baylor ready for this? You know their students are. And Berkic boots it to the end zone.
Berkic is such great tradition. Love to watch how he plays the game.
And he's going to keep the ball and scamper. Nice gain on the first down of about six as we check out the Chick-fil-A impact players.
He's going to need help tonight, obviously. They want to attack the Sooners. John Lovett, they're going to see a rotation of three. Seven's probably their best all-round back. Denzel Mims, five, can win one-on-one. He'll have to do that. Gallimore on the inside of this defense, and Kenneth Murray, the leader, anxious to get the Sooners back to playing good defense.
Again, Brewer takes off, slips a tackle, and spins for a first down. It's the Sooner defense that has been ripped apart the last couple of games.
It really is. They want to start fast and try to get a stop here. But the Bears, in their first couple of plays, they pick up the first down. Back-to-back quarterback draws where they're getting Brewer settled down. They made a point in our meetings yesterday of saying, you know, last few games and maybe throughout the year, we haven't played with urgency all the time. We want to get Brewer playing with urgency instead of waiting till late in the game. They want to start fast.
End around, and they give the ball to Josh Fleeks, and he's knocked down after a two-yard gain. Rule admitted maybe he had been a little bit too conservative and trying to feel out the opponent early in the game. They would fall behind frequently.
Yeah, and he said part of that has to do with maybe, you know, the offensive line giving up some sacks and a few negative plays. They've relied on trusting their defense, winning with field position. They've won turnover margins often, so they've had to wait to really put their foot on the gas. And tonight, because it's Lincoln Riley and Jalen Hurts, they feel they can't wait to do that.
Brewer flushed out and delivers a high throw. It was off the hands of Jamichael Hasty out of the backfield. It'll be third and long.
They brought Kenneth Murray there late and actually had some good pressure. It's going to be a concern. If Brewer's back there, Chris, holding the ball longer than a hitch or two, this offensive line, I don't think they can handle the athletic ability, the twists and stunts, and the way they'll bring pressure from those linebackers. Murray and White both will come after that quarterback. So he's got to have that internal clock. If it's not there, he's got to take off or throw it away. Can't take sacks.
Yeah, he's been sacked a lot, 23 times, taking a lot of hits this season. Sooners don't come after him. Only a three-man rush, but they still get him. Ronnie Perkins off the edge, and the Sooners do get a stop.
Well, Casey Phillips, the left tackle right here, just cannot deal with the athletic ability and the speed around the edge. Just does not do a good job of getting back, getting lateral and using, and maybe underappreciated the quickness there of Perkins. And you can see the back there slide out because he thought the left tackle Phillips had that handled. They just rush three and get home.
Isaac Power to punt, and Kirk CeeDee Lamb, the regular punt returner, is not out. Check the head last week on CeeDee Lamb at Oklahoma's victory over Iowa State. Boom, he lowers his head as a punt returner, loses the helmet. He didn't come out of the game. He played a monster game, but media reports began to circulate just this afternoon after he had done plenty of media. It was a feature on College Game Day that he would not be able to play because he didn't pass the protocol. Nobody told Maria pregame, but there he is, Kirk, with a stocking hat as the Sooner offense takes over here from their own 47. Talk about the impact of the game plan if, in fact, he can't go tonight. A significant playmaker, the deep threat in this Oklahoma team. This is Kennedy Brooks, who turns the corner and gets to midfield.
Well, first you have to remember, they average 249 yards a game on the ground. Jalen Hurts, if anything, is going to have to run a few more times tonight with CeeDee Lamb down. He averages about 14 carries a game. The other thing is you're going to see some of these younger receivers, the true freshmen. Lincoln Riley telling us they're ready to grow up this week, so they'll have their opportunity along with Charleston Rambo.
Looks again with a stiff arm and muscles his way for a gain to the 46. It'll set up third and three. It becomes a more ground-heavy attack.
Yeah, I mean, they typically want to run the ball to set up their play-action pass game. That's who they are. And, you know, whether CeeDee Lamb is out there or not, that's their personality. That's their identity. Now it just takes on that much more of an identity because of not having their go-to guy, the top receiver in the country. But they're not going to change who they are. If anything, more physical, more run, more controlling the line of scrimmage.
Well, here's a pre-snap flag, which will change the complexion of this third down play. It's a false start. Rarely do the Sooners even get to third down.
A false start by number 77 of the offense. Penalty, and it's still third down.
Eric Swenson, Phil Snow, the defensive coordinator for the Bears, saying only about 10 times a game, 90 times this season. That's all they've been to third down.
Yeah, it's funny hearing Phil Snow tell us, he's like, I'm going through the third down team. He goes, I got the third and one to take for five plays all year. To win to get him to third down, right?
Bears crowd the line, come after Hurts on third down. The blitz is picked up, and the pass is caught. Different guys will have to step up. That's A.D. Miller as they move the sticks.
Watch Jalen Hurts. Hitch, ball is out. Great timing. Ball is actually out early before the veteran A.D. Miller even comes out of his break. Jalen Hurts early in this game just settling in. Felt good on that throw on that third down and long. Had time to be able to see it and deliver the ball accurately.
Brooks again. Turns the corner. And bangs down for another first down to the 23-yard line. Stopped by Miller and Braylon Arnold.
But you play 3-3-5 for Baylor. Three down linemen, three linebackers, five defensive backs. They play that scheme because they play in the Big 12 where people spread you out. It gives them a chance to get more speed on the field. But you better be ready to be physical when OU comes to town with this running game and that offensive line.
Averaging about 250 a game on the ground. Hurts slings it, and the catch is made by Nick Basqua, knocked out of bounds after a short gain. Jalen, a 73% passer. That's second behind LSU's Joe Burrow.
Yeah, I think Lincoln Riley does a really good job. Well, he's done a good job with all his quarterbacks, but I think he's done a really good job with a quarterback that hasn't had a lot of time to be on campus, has picked up this system, has become a leader in the weight room, in the locker room. It's hard to do when you come over from another school, but right away these players realize the alpha personality that he has.
Play action on second and five. Hurts knocked down as he delivers the throw. And it falls way short. Jordan Williams came off the edge there.
Yeah, they brought pressure up the middle. And it affected his follow-through. But I think the ball may have just slipped out of his hand. Watch this at the end here. He gets hit. Can't really follow through on the football. Ball kind of took off on him. At first, I thought maybe somebody at the line of scrimmage may have tipped it. But that ball just kind of floated awkwardly out of his hand. Another third down.
Bears a huge number of quarterback pressures, 200 of them on the season. That's big. Can they get near Hurts? Nobody with a hand on the ground on third and five. Hurts looking to run, but he can't escape. Slung down by Bravion Roy for a sack.
Anytime you get Jalen Hurts to third down, you got to be concerned about his scramble. Watch Roy in the middle. Now, he's a big man, but he's over 330 pounds. But look him. He wins his battle, and then he's able to be there with his eyes up and be able to bring down Jalen Hurts. His push in the middle tonight, essential, because Jalen likes to scramble up the middle.
Berkic, a freshman kicker who takes over for Austin Cyber, the all-time Big 12 leading scorer. This from 39 yards to remain perfect on the season. And it will go just inside the upright. 11 for 11. Could not scramble for that first down. Oklahoma settles for three. And Baylor's offense goes back to work. Hasty from the goal line. Setter steps, but can't get beyond the 23. Reaction on first down. Brewer on a slam, and he bounced the ball to Denzel Mims, who was running free in the secondary.
Yeah, This is just a miscommunication by the Oklahoma secondary, where you have two defenders that are working into the flat. I'm thinking this safety broke late, but they end up busting coverage. You can see him late, see how he's late trying to get back to recover, to get to the middle of the field. And that's a mistake. That's something that really cost Oklahoma against Kansas State and Iowa State last week.
Second down throw across the middle, going down to make a tough catch is Mims. He's known for that. He just had a monster late game heroics against TCU, that overtime survival.
Brewer makes this throw, and he'd love to have the one back, or he has the touchdown. That is an incredible effort there by Mims.
When you make a throw that bad, are you just trying to muscle the ball?
Yeah, I mean, it's almost like you see it, and you probably muscle. You try to maybe short arm it. You're just trying to make that perfect throw.
There's another shot. Sliding move there by Chris Platt on the sidelines. He's got it for another first down to the 47.
See, you have an Oklahoma defense that's reeling coming into the game the way they played against Kansas State and Iowa State. That's why I like the tempo. I like attacking the secondary because that's where they've had a lot of miscues.
Brewer on the move will now cut it back and dart up the middle. He's got sneaky quickness. That's a 7-yard gain.
He's got that defense flying. He does a nice job with his vision there to show you what kind of a natural runner he is, cutting back against the grain. But they've got all of a sudden Oklahoma on their heels, and this is where they want to be to help that offensive line, more in that attack mode that we talked about.
On second and three, going to bounce the run outside, and then slower on his shoulder is John Levitt, the junior from New Jersey, who's created more explosive runs than any Baylor back, and they do move to six again.
Alex Grinch, the new defensive coordinator from Oklahoma. Of course, they had a tough year last year. They fired Mike Stoops in the middle of the year. McNeil took over. They bring Alex Grinch over, who was at Ohio State last year, as a co-defensive coordinator. He loves to attack the line of scrimmage. A lot of twists, a lot of games up front from that D-line.
And they come after Brewer again. It's a low throw. Got the ball out quickly, and Fleeks goes down, but it's just a 2-yard gain.
Yeah, and I was talking to him this week. He said, you know, when I got there, I was just trying to get these guys to realize what they're capable of being defensively and almost redefine the culture and get their confidence back and show them who they can be. It's not just offense with Oklahoma. We want to create our own identity on defense.
They use the word fail a couple times in our conversation based on what has happened the last couple of weeks, though. Second and long, Brewer took a look and now just takes off, and he cannot escape Kenneth Murray, the middle linebacker, the top tackler on this defense.
Yeah, he's been around for 3 years, really instinctive player, does a nice job here of being patient. Watch seven, the back, try to pick up a block. They're setting up that quarterback draw, but he doesn't even make a block. Love it, slow to go out and attack Murray, and Murray in space with that experience, very, very tough to handle for any back.
He and Neville Gallimore, the nose guard, the two really elite players in this Oklahoma defense. Bears need six on third. Three-man rush. Brewer with plenty of time. Throws a dart over the middle. Taking a huge shot, but holding on is R.J. Sneed. And here comes a flag.
The flag. A personal foul targeting by number 23 of the defense. Finnegan is half the distance to the goal, and it's an automatic first down. The play is under further review.
I'd like to bring Dave Kutai in here and ask Dave if he's considered a defenseless player there because he hits him with his shoulder into the head. I would assume he's got to be defenseless there.
Held.
After further review, the ruling on the field of a catch is confirmed. However, there is no foul for targeting. It's a first down.
So no 15-yard penalty. White can stay in the game. And that's why it was important that Sneed somehow held on to the football there.
Yeah, and it goes back to that whole, is he considered defenseless or is he considered just a runner or a receiver there that got his feet established?
Baylor has a player, a safety, Chris Miller, who's been hit for targeting three times. He was suspended for the last game against TCU. That's what happens when you're targeted three times in the season. He's back tonight. But the Bears, meanwhile, first down from the 26. And he puts it to London in the flat. He's got space. And the first down, and McCoy barreling down inside the five. First and goal as the back out of the backfield makes a big play.
a good read here. You're going to see to Brewer's left, the nickelback, Hiles. He's reading him right here. Is he going out or is he coming in? He's got to feel that. Once he comes to the quarterback, he's able to dump it off to him, and there's nobody left to pick him up.
Backs are very effective receivers in this offense. All three of the backs have caught the ball effectively. Love it in the game on first and goal. Brewer going to keep it. And he scores standing up.
10 plays and a 78 yards.
And a great job recovering as the PAT is good from a terrible throw. It's a sure touchdown. Trey Brown back deep to receive the kick. Noah Rauschenberg, who's missed 5 games with an injury, is back. He's known for his kickoff leg. And he drives it to the 2. Brown trying to get sideways. A flag flies. Brown still trying to stay alive, and he does get free. And the kicker unable to grab him. Again, a flag down as Brown loses the ball at the end. Sooners recover at the 16-yard line. So a lot to sort out. The flag came out very, very early. Braden Willis eventually recovered Brown's fumble.
Well, there's a lot going on there.
There was.
Holding by number 8 of the return team. The gentleman will be 10 yards from the spot of the foul, and it'll be a first down.
Region. You're going to see that CeeDee Lamb and he have a special connection. It goes back to Jalen's first days in Norman when he crashed on Lamb's couch. Jalen rolls out, knocked down in the end zone, and heaves it as there was a miscommunication there. Blake Lynch brought the pressure. Maria?
Well, speaking of CeeDee Lamb, we finally got the official news from Oklahoma that he's out with a medical issue. You know, I spoke to CeeDee this week leading into this game, and he was so excited to be able to make plays with that guy, Jalen Hurts. So he's sitting on the sidelines now, trying to keep his team into it, trying to make sure that he's bringing energy on the sidelines right now, but will not be coming into the game tonight, guys.
All right, Maria and Chris, you just talked about that chemistry and that comfort. There's a miscommunication there with a freshman receiver.
Brooks slashes for a short gain. Serious smoke screen. You don't often have a player who's ruled out medically sit down and do a feature for College Game Day and have a phone call with Maria. Go through the warm-up with helmet and shoulder pads on.
I've never seen that. First time. Another big third down here for OU, this time deep in their own territory.
Who will step up and make these clutch catches with a big play weapon not in there?
They're showing outside pressure. Here's how they're walking him up. Here it comes.
Hurts. And escape again. They got him. Blake Lynch, the linebacker, and the Bears force a punt.
And they brought pressure from the outside. They walked both their outside linebackers, their hybrid players, here and here, and they bring them. But that's not the only two that apply the pressure. You also see in the inside, James Lockhart, 9, gets free. And Jalen Hurts, his head is spinning, trying to figure out where that pressure is coming. Nice job of dialing it up there by Phil Snow and fooling OU, the offensive line, and Jalen Hurts on third down.
Only the 23rd punt this year for Reeves Munshow. They haven't had to punt very often. It's a high one. Graylin Arnold will get away from it. It bounces with backspin, touched about the 45-yard line. And that's where the Bears will take over. Hasty is the back next to Brewer. And they begin from the 46. Brewer backpedals, and it's batted down at the line of scrimmage. Excellent pressure by the fine nose guard.
This is what Oklahoma is dealing with. It's that long pass play, man-to-man on the outside right here, right? But what I think catches them, and the reason they, Alex Grinch got upset, was their nickelback right there. Radley Hiles, he kind of got stuck in between. Do I take the quarterback? Do I take the back? He starts on the back, then comes down on the quarterback. And this is what happened after that play, after the touchdown, is he had to deal with Alex Grinch on the sideline, basically saying, do your job by staying with that back.
He said it rather emphatically.
Yeah.
Brewer is pressured, but he escapes, and he's going to dive head first for a first down at the 42. Big part of this game so far, Brewer scrambling.
Watch the linebacker clear out with the motion, and then the awareness by Brewer to see the open right there. He just steps up. They blitz that other outside linebacker, and once again, the middle of the Sooners defense is open for Brewer to take off for yards with his legs.
Man, he just curls his body forward into defenders. He delivers blows.
He does.
Takes them.
Yeah. He said at a meeting the other day, he's like, I'm tired of taking them. It's fun to deliver them once in a while.
He's not 100%. He's been knocked around this year, but few on this field are 100% at this point in the season. And give it off from the running back, and this is Hasty, and he's going to be slung down by Murray, but not before a 9-yard gain.
See, this is where you attack Oklahoma, to me, running the ball. Get to the edge. You can get to the corner, you can seal that edge, and you can force that secondary to have to tackle. This time Murray's able to chase it down, but not until 9 yards downfield.
Sneak by Brewer for a first down. You're right. Kansas State, Iowa State just killed the Sooners with those wide.
Yeah, anytime you wanted to go wide, get to the perimeter the last couple of weeks, Kansas State, especially Iowa State in that second half last week. And it doesn't just mean running. You can just throw the quick pass, the quick screen to the outside, but force that secondary to make tackles.
And the Bears, again, it's the first time in a game this big for all of these players, acquitting themselves well in the first quarter. Trying to build to this lead. First down from the 30. Play action again. Brewer takes it downfield. Shabbos has got a touchdown. He's the main threat. He's a Baylor receiver. And the Bears back-to-back. Two touchdowns. Two in the first quarter tonight. Brown comes up to receive the short kickoff from the 9. And a flag comes in here. He's spun down. This one may be on the attempted tackle.
Holding by number 18 of the receiving team. That penalty is declined. An illegal block in the back by number 8 of the receiving team. That penalty is half the distance to the goal, and it's first down.
Thought they had a face mask there for sure.
Henley moves the ball to the 6. This is a new position for Oklahoma's offense. They go with a different formation, a 2-back block. Handoff inside to Ramondre Stevenson, a big physical player. But Rick, they have been a tremendous first quarter team. And they're outscoring people 114-21. Not used to being behind early.
No, they're not at all. But I think they need a drive where they can just kind of have some success, pick up a couple first downs, get better field position, try to get their confidence back.
Hurts keeps it, gets to the edge.
When in doubt,
dives down for a first down near the 18-yard line.
Yeah, that's who you rely on. When in doubt, you got to go to a veteran. Jalen Hurts knows how to make plays, especially with his legs, being able to outrun some defenders. That time he got just to the outside of Blake Lynch. And once he broke contain, he had the speed to get it to the first down marker.
You fake it to Brooks, Hurts, delivers, and the catch made on the sideline there by A.D. Miller, the senior from Dallas, who only had 3 catches this season, has 2 tonight.
Yeah, and again, second time we've seen Hurts work back to that left boundary and be in sync with A.D. Miller. Veteran receiver that is going to have to step his game up tonight with CeeDee Lamb out, and he has in his first quarter.
22-yard gain. And Brooks tests the right side, slips one tackle, wrestled down, 3-yard gain. James Lynch got the tackle, one with Lockhart.
Now, OU runs that counter play, and they have for these last 4 years, and it kind of become a staple of Lincoln Riley. That time, Baylor, nice job of chasing this out from behind.
Hurts is chased. Can he escape? Ball on the ground, it's a scrum. Baylor, Blake Lynch at the bottom of that pile. Trying to spin away, just drop the football. Quarter. Brewer, another look downfield, and another big run. Sliding down inside the 5, Baylor threatens again. What a first.
1-3, this is a big series here for OU.
Brewer keeping straight ahead, scores for a second time, and Baylor building a big lead.
The same play they scored in their last touchdown when they brought the right right guard Newman around. Quarterback power. And they just don't have enough defenders on that side of the football. They use a formation to get him out of position. They bring that right guard around, and Kenneth Murray unable to make the tackle.
So Brewer run for a couple. Threw the touchdown pass to Mims. What a start with the junior from Austin Lake Travis High School. John Mayers. First year, and all of a sudden, they are hammering the defending champions of this conference 21-3. A lot of football to be played, but Baylor is just building momentum here.
Yeah, they
couldn't tell he was up 18. He is a man of few words. What answers can Jalen Hurts have? They swing it to Stevenson out of the backfield, and big man shows a nice burst, and it's a first down out across the 35.
Yeah, simplify, get your athletes out in space, and let them do some damage themselves. We've seen Brooks tonight a lot. Stevenson, the junior college player, he's got the size at 236 pounds, and that time shows he's got some burst as well.
I feel like he's ready for a big stretch run. And Hurts into the clear, shedding tackles, slides down in Baylor territory at the 45, but the Sooners trying to strike back quickly.
Yeah, a good read here. Watch him read the defensive end. He kind of stays on this drive. Watch how long he rides here. This man to commit down. Once he commits down, he pulls it. Now he's outside with blockers. Good job by the receivers of stalk blocking there to give him even more room to run.
And they hand it off inside to Stevenson.
And interesting, you know, in the past when you had Kyler Murray or you had Baker Mayfield, if they would have digged themselves a hole like this, they'd go back to the passing game, right? And it's interesting how now you go back to Jalen Hurts in the running game, the zone read. With CeeDee Lamb out, it's even more of an emphasis and more that they need from the quarterback Hurts and his running ability.
Hurts from the pocket this time delivers a high throw, and yet Basquin makes the catch, knocked out hard, picks up about six. It'll be third down and short.
That's where they want to be with Jalen Hurts' ability to run and throw. They cleared out the corner who was playing man-to-man. Watch him clear him out there. Creates that nice opening there to the boundary. Nice long throw and accurate throw there by Hurts.
Capital One line, the game shows they need two. Bravion Roy, the big nose tackle, number 99, back in the game for this play. Two back look. Hurts rolling, got a throw for it, and the catch is made. Just enough for the first down to Charleston Rambo.
And Rambo's really the guy that's got to be able to come up with the big plays tonight. Not an easy throw and catch there on third and short. I thought they might use the quarterback run game there with two backs there to lead the way, but instead they roll him out and Rambo has to go up high to make that catch. Secures it for that first.
They fake it to Stevenson. Hurts looking to run, and he'll be spun down by James Lockhart, the former Texas A&M Aggie.
These outside linebacker slash safety slash nickelbacks, whatever you might want to call them, Jordan Williams, 38, Blake Lynch, they do a little bit of everything in this defense, and they're very, very active. Lockhart, of course, is up front along with James Lynch and Roy, the three down linemen. But man, I'm impressed with these outside linebackers, 38 and 2, doing a really good job tonight of being active against the pass and also against the run.
Lockhart, one of the leaders, 37 college football game. He's seen a lot. Hurts took a look outside, runs right back into the middle of traffic, and is going to be dropped behind the line by T.J. Franklin, a true freshman, and Jordan Williams.
You know, Phil Snow is saying to these outside, these hybrid linebackers, get upfield. Do not let them get outside of us. They're forcing them. See how they're blitzing them quite a bit. They want him to go back underneath. Jalen Hurts has such ability to run, and he can get wide with his speed. They're forcing him back in where the end of that teeth of that defense. So Baylor with the inside linebackers and that defensive line is.
Sooners may have two plays to get the 11 yards. Here's third down. Baylor crowds the line. Hurts has time, though. Steps up. It's a long throw into traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Braylon Arnold. Arnold down the sidelines. Can he beat Hurts? No,
the quarterback gets off the block and forces him out, but it's a...
The Cyclones, not by the Bears tonight.
Brewer from the pocket, fires for the end zone!
Touchdown, Mims! His second!
And Baylor is pouring it on against OU.
So you're saying you wanted a platform to send a message to the committee. Well, they're off to a pretty good start here. It's 28-3. Protection is there. He gets a matchup that he wants. Does a nice job of looking that safety off, but gets the matchup again with his man, Mims. He feels Mims can beat anybody in this Oklahoma secondary one-on-one. That's the second time tonight he's done it for a touchdown.
Baylor has been the somehow, some way team. Just create ways to win tight games. They've created this national stage. They feel disrespected at 13.
There's 11 minutes to go in the second quarter. You know, so it just starts small, little victories.
As feeling this was going to be their night. Kennedy knocked down, and Brooks across the 30. He's got the first down yard.
There are people around the country right now hearing second quarter score out of Waco. Baylor 28, Oklahoma 3, and saying, what? What's going on? It's one of those kind of starts to this game right now. But OU has, they've got to be able to find out who is going to step up on the perimeter. I think it needs to be Charleston Rambo 14 with CeeDee Lamb out as far as making plays.
Play action across the middle, and there's the third catch for A.D. Miller. Dropped the ball, hammered by Chris Miller. Had it, couldn't hold it.
Yeah, I think Chris Miller got in there. By the way, he's not playing in last week's game because he's had three targeting calls. New rule this year after three targeting calls, you're out. So it's nice to see him still be aggressive and play smart. Comes in there with his hand and dislodges that football against A.D. Miller. See that right hand kind of in the contact with his shoulder and his upper body, charred that ball loose.
He plays 100 miles an hour. Got to play within the rules, though.
Yep.
Because he earned those three targetings. Hurts has good protection, but just takes off. It's one read and go, and why not? Well, you could do that out near midfield, another first down.
See, he's reading this before he takes off on that quarterback draw. He's trying to feel the linebacker there. If the linebacker drops too far back, that's what gives him a chance to take off and run. He's just kind of watching this guy. If he drops out too far, then he's going to follow the lineman. So watch him. Kind of look at that, feel that. Then he decides, okay, I can take off and use it as a quarterback draw, and he follows the big fellow there, Robinson, and gets positive yards.
He's talking about Chris Miller, the senior from Frisco, Texas. He's being attended to, has now gotten to his feet, and he's shaking out that right leg. So we're seeing the Sooners try to answer again, but doing so mostly on the ground.
6 of 10 for 65 yards here so far.
You know, he's a guy that one out of every pass attempts for Hurts goes downfield. That's a very high percentage, and usually he's looking for CeeDee Lamb. Without Lamb in there, it's a totally different looking Oklahoma offense. They've been a big downfield team all season long.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they have been quick strike. I mean, as good as anybody in the country at scoring quickly, which is kind of, again, an MO of what we've seen from Lincoln Riley's offenses over the years.
Brooks, tackled. You talk about a yard per attempt, which is one measure they use to talk about your efficiency. 13.3 is a massive number.
Yeah. I think there was number two coming into the night in the country in pass plays of 20 yards or more with 53 of them. So, yeah, I mean, and that's why, even with CeeDee Lamb out, I think they still feel, because there's so much time to go in this game, they've worked themselves back into this game.
Second and 7, Hurts from the pocket, delivers a long throw. And the catch is made there by Lee Morris, and the veteran knocked out by Lynch, another first down.
Yeah, and when you get these opportunities, you've got to capitalize on. Watch the safety right here, and watch Miller work down the middle of his defense. Safety comes up right there, you got it. Got to take that throw, take that shot. Those are quick strikes that if you can hit, make an accurate throw downfield, that's a touchdown. You're right back in the game.
Brooks has to try to bounce it. There was pick penetration, fights back near the line of scrimmage, but that play was in trouble from the start.
Yeah, eyes on the football, sitting back in zone. What's great about that is when you have eyes on the football, you have a veteran defense that is not hesitating. They are firing towards that ball carrier. Leverage, a big part of Bill Snow's message this week, and tackling. He thought those are the two things that they had to do against the OU run game.
Three-man rush on second and 10. So Hurts decides to run it, and he'll muscle for about five. It'll be third down.
Yeah, they've been watching Charlie Brewer run that quarterback draw. And they're saying, well, we've got a quarterback that can run that draw, too. So they get some positive yards to set up this third down here and manageable. Remember, they call a pass. Baylor's thinking as much about the threat of the scramble by Hurts as much as defending the pass play here.
Oklahoma down 25. Desperate need the answer right here. Hurts has plenty of time. It's a downfield shot. Looping ball out of the hands of Baskin right near the pylon. JT Woods in coverage. It's fourth down and five.
Yeah, he's on the slot. He's got room to work to the outside. Does a really good job with his route. The ball just underthrown. He left JT Woods. The progressive pylon cam shows you he's inbounds, just unable to hold on to an underthrown ball there by Jalen Hurts.
Offense on the field, of course, down 25, fourth and five. Sooners only gone for it five times on fourth down this season. Haven't had to. Empty backfield look. You'd expect a quarterback run and whistle before the play, and Oklahoma will spend a timeout to talk about it. We'll see what Riley has cooked up on fourth down and five as we come back. Off the timeout, Oklahoma facing a fourth and five as they try to cut into this lead before halftime. Brooks is the back. Hurts back to throw, and knocked down at the line of scrimmage. A flag is down in the secondary. Jordan Williams, who has been battling through an upset stomach throughout this drive,
the ball was tipped. There's no foul on the play.
This was the personality of this team.
Defensive holding by number 11 of the defense. It's a 10-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Well, that certainly changes the complexion. That conference, even though the ball was deflected by Williams, the defensive holding stands. It wasn't a pass interference call, so the automatic first down, and Rule is hot.
Yeah, and the difference is if it's pass interference with a tip ball, then they're able to wave it off. There was a miscommunication. They were able to get together, find out it's defensive holding, and you don't wave it off with defensive holding.
Wasn't a whole lot, to be honest with you, by Big 12 standards.
Yeah.
Kind of tried to grab him. I don't know if he successfully did. But the penalty on their physical corner, Houston, sets the Sooners up for the first down at the 23. And the defense has to go back to work.
Talk about, talk about catching a break for the Sooners. See if they're able to capitalize.
That's their first penalty tonight. Sooners in a two-back look. But Hurts keeps it. And has a couple blocks on the edge. And is forced out at the 15. Picked up eight.
And again, they go back to that zone read where he's reading the best defensive lineman, James Lynch, instead of blocking him, just read him. Make him have to make a decision, and Jalen Hurts again able to get wide of him and pick up 8 yards. Now they widen Lynch out there to the right of the offense.
Hurts still has the football, pressured, and fires it to the sideline. Terrell Bernard came after him. The crowd wants a grounding call. Don't get it.
Yeah, they collapse Lynch inside, and here comes Bernard and the pressure that he brings from his left middle linebacker spot. See how he blows up those linemen that are pulling? Nobody left there to pick up Bernard, who's been active himself there at the second level of this defense.
He's outside of the pocket. But Bernard's playing with a heavily wrapped right hand. That was a development, I think, since the start of this game. He's a guy that had 19 tackles in the win over TCU. Brooks inside. Excuse me, that's Stevenson muscling inside. It's a first down and goal now for Oklahoma.
They pick up the big first down there on third and short. You're right about Bernard, Chris. You know, he's had to step up. They lost one of their great leaders in Clay Johnston after six games. Led the team in tackles, so they ended up moving Bernard, who was playing where Jordan Williams in. They were kind of rotating. They moved him to the inside, and he's done a nice job of playing there for that leader, Johnston, who's been out.
And first and goal, Hurts took a quick look, now just takes off. Slams for a ball on the ground again. It's another scrum at the six-yard line.
Well, you talk about a collision between a quarterback and a safety in Henry Black. The football came loose. But you talk two guys hitting each other as hard as they possibly could there. The Jalen Hurts picks up momentum. Watch this hit here.
Listen to it.
Ball came out. Shield came off. Ball's out. Yeah, you see the shield off of his helmet. That was a big-time collision.
Hurts still in the game. Empty backfield. Looking to run again. Another big collision right at the five. Once again, it was Chris Miller, the big hitter.
I'm telling you,
give it as good as he got there.
Phil Snow must have told his team, listen, Hurts is going to run the ball, and when he does, we are going to punish him. We're going to hit him from every angle and make him not want to run the football again. Because right now, these linebackers and three Chris Miller, they are lowering their shoulder at full speed in this
game. I think Jalen Hurts killed the will of Jalen Hurts. I'm not sure that's possible. Third and goal. He has taken a couple of huge shots in the last two plays. Brooks is the back.
Another timeout by Lincoln Riley up at the top.
Big moment here, Cassidy. Oklahoma still down 25. It's been a long march. Third and goal from the five. Hurts has time. Zips it. Touchdown. Catch made in traffic by Austin Stogner. True freshman tight end. His first career touchdown is Hurts delivered a dart from the pocket.
Yeah, a really nice route by the freshman. I just want to make sure he held on to the football here. Look at Morph to the outside, back to the inside. He's able to hold on to that in traffic. A couple different defenders trying to get their hands on the ball. Really, really good timing there. And a good job. You know, Calcaterra, their starting tight end, is out. So they relied on Lee Morris and Stogner to step up for him. And he does a nice job there securing that for a big touchdown for the Sooners.
Sooners have to work for it. They're helped by that defensive holding penalty, which prolonged the drive. They cut into the lead now, 28-10. It's just a half game ahead of the Raiders now in that divisional race.
So used to seeing OU score fast. That time, 14 plays for their 75 yards and a touchdown.
Fleeks breaks free and bounces out near the 30. Chris Fleeks.
Yeah, I don't think the Bear would go that route either.
Inside of 5 minutes before halftime. And Baylor back to work. Brewer has been an effective runner. You got to feel like the Sooners are going to pick up on that. Jalen Redmond stopped him there. Now a scuffle after the whistle.
If you're an OU fan, you're kind of waiting for something to stop the bleeding, create a spark, and they are able to put that drive together. We mentioned 14 plays, 75 yards. That got the offense going. Now you wonder if this defense can get back to playing with a little bit of an edge to them here. This is a big series for the Sooners yet again defensively.
And they create a takeaway. There's been a drought. 5 games since they had a takeaway. Only 6 on the season. Brewer from the pocket delivered. Catch made, knocked down short of the first down. Is Chris Platt will be third in about 5.
Nice job by Alex Grinch that time, mixing in some zone. The previous time, that same play was called. It was man-to-man. They threw that same route. The corner was not there to make the play. On the football, that time, sitting in zone, he's able to make a play and set up this third down.
And they're giving forward progress, so it's 3rd and 3. It's the third down play this Baylor offense has had to face tonight. Brewer looking for the slant and delivers. Catch made. Sneed out of that
slot position, catches the dart, first down near midfield.
He's reading the safety here. He's got two slants coming in. He's going to kind of feel this safety right here. Whichever slant he jumps, he's going to go the other route. You see how he takes this slant? So he's got the next slant right behind that, and he's able to get it in. Good read, and again, Brewer in sync, in rhythm, reading this defense perfectly, play after play.
It's bad news, Kirk. Denzel Mims, the big play receiver for the Baylor Bears. He was limping all the way across the field, able to jog off. He's looking at his right calf. So the man has two touchdowns tonight on the sideline for the moment on first down. Hasty around the edge quickly, slams right into Kenneth Murray. Physical tackle and about a four-yard gain.
Yeah, a lot of people knock the Big 12. They don't play defense in the Big 12. That's been a knock over the years. All I know is tonight, I've heard that. Tonight in Waco, there's some collisions. I mean, we're seeing some people get hit
but
tonight.
But it's justified to some degree.
Yeah, I'm not saying it's not. I'm just saying tonight I'm enjoying the contest. I'm enjoying seeing people get hit.
And the defense in green has been exceptional. On second down, Brewer again takes off and weaves his way and dives for another first down.
He's not going to wow you with his speed, but I'll tell you what, man, this guy is instinctive. When he pulls it down on that quarterback crawl, patiently waiting for the blocks to get downfield, he almost sets them up and it cuts behind them.
Short throw, and the catch is made by Fleeks. Brewer's a guy that followed Baker Mayfield at the Football Factory, the quarterback factory at Lake Travis High School. He was going to go to SMU. He had no Power 5 offers. Chad Morris, the connection with Lake Travis, until Matt Rhule called him and said, you know what?
I hear you're a winner.
We got a job for you here. I hear you're a winner, right?
Yeah, I hear you're a winner. I've never seen you or I know about your family. I've read up on you. It sounds good, but until his dad and Charlie came on campus, he really didn't know much about it.
Brewer delivers a shot across the middle. He may not wow you with the measurables, but he is a winner. Got to the state championship game, lost it as a junior, came back, won it as a senior. Talk about 6A. That's serious football down here.
Oh, man. Yeah, I tell you what, you play at Lake Travis, where it's high school football, as far as pressure. Think of Friday Night Lights. I mean, you take the field in Lake Travis, you're 15, 16, 17 years old. I don't care what you face in college. I don't know if there's going to be anything as big as what you feel as a youngster playing high school football in a big-time program in this state.
So Mims back on the field. Baylor going to spend a timeout here, letting the play clock wind all the way down before they face this third and 11, trying to add to an 18-point lead before the break here in Waco. Brewer on a hot streak. He's completed 11 of his last 12. Sooners rush just three, steps up and delivers a long throw. Catch made, first down, Mims. Inside the 30.
Same play as the touchdown where he gets man-to-man. We showed you pre-snap where he's going to work to the outside, work that post corner. Beats that defensive back every time. He had a nice cushion to work with. Gave him a little bit of an inside move against Motley. And once again, he and Brewer in sync.
Now looking to throw in first down. Wanted to take a peek down the end zone. Instead, just takes off. And this time will slide down at the 22-yard line. Clock running. They still have two timeouts to work with.
That second timeout by head coach there, Matt Rhule.
Chris Palika will give us the answer in the athletic trivia question, which seemed a little too obvious by your standards, Bear.
Well, sometimes the answer to the athletic trivia question, Occam's razor, does apply. It is UCF back there in 2015, when had the Ofer, and then 2 years later, that magical season, and looks like Baylor off to a pretty good start in pursuit of 10 out of 9.
It is, and Baylor, of course, the circumstances unique here. We talked about the scandal, and there were people around the country who were saying, I don't think they should be allowed to have a football program. Right, the Title IX violations were very, very serious. The nature of them, of course, extremely serious. The investigation technically continues here. They don't seem too worried about that. And now a chance to get to 10-0 with a milestone victory here.
I don't think with 41 seconds and one timeout, the way they play, they're not thinking about field goal. They're still attacking downfield and trying to find a one-on-one matchup that they can win against this OU secondary.
Need three for a first down. Still have the one timeout left.
Mims at the top. They have a safety there to help. He's moving to the middle.
He's looking that direction. Again, just takes off. Weaves his way. Knocked down. The clock will stop momentarily as they move the sticks.
A good job of getting the first down. And with that timeout, they were able to say, hey, we get a first down. Here's our play. Let's get it called. That way they can try to preserve as much time as they can. They need to pick it up here. Hold on to that timeout.
Clock moving 25 and counting. Brewer from the pocket. Delivers a short throw, getting out of bounds is Platt. So they keep the timeout, move the ball to the 16.
Well, they have a lot of receivers for this OU defense. Thornton, 81. Mims makes a lot of plays. You just saw Platt. Leaks can make plays, 21. R.J. Sneed. We got Jared Atkinson, who's a junior. I mean, you got six guys that they can throw the football to that they feel can win one-on-one matchups.
Yeah, they had seven guys coming in with double-digit catches. That'd be a balanced receiving core. Brewer looking for the end zone. Loops the ball over the head of Sneed. He was tangled up in coverage there. No flag. Bradley Hiles, the linebacker, was on him.
Fans booing. There was some pushing and shoving there by 44 Bradley Hiles. Again, if I'm Brewer, I'm looking into that secondary. I'm looking at the safeties. I'm trying to see where I can get one of my talented receivers matched up one-on-one. Mims again at the top.
Platt comes in motion. Brewer looking to the left. Flush. Scrambling. Fires. End zone. And was trying to get Hasty out of the backfield free. It's fourth down with 7 seconds. And here comes the field goal team.
Yeah, a nice job by the pass rush by the Sooners that time. Did not give Brewer much of a chance at all to let that play develop. Gallimore in the middle, watch 90. Get a good push there. Good athletic ability for the big fella. Well over 300 pounds and yet moves very, very quickly. Forced Brewer out of the pocket. That play really never had a chance. Good coverage as well.
A 13-play drive covering 61 yards. And now John Mayers, freshman, 28 yards. Been very reliable this season. And he knocks it through. Oklahoma has scored, drive prolonged by a penalty, and then Baylor answers with three. And it's a squib kick, which will just use up all the time in a half, assuming that they can tackle Trey Brown, and they do.
So I'm in there in the locker room at halftime, and I know you. I'm thinking, let's take this first time, this first drive, and let's put points on the board, get back in this game.
Rauschenberg drives the kick to the goal line, and Brown flips a couple of tackles, knocked down across the 25-yard line.
Touchdowns, a dream start in that first half for Brewer.
And off the first play is Rambo. They're trying to involve the speedy sophomore receiver. Picks up six on first down.
Yeah, and you'll see a little bit more tempo, not only because they're down 21, but I think they feel that that's a comfort zone for Jalen Hurts, and it gets Baylor maybe a little bit more on their heels.
Dumps the ball off to Brooks out of the backfield. He's got first down yardage, takes a big shot at the 37. Maria, what did you learn at halftime?
Well, Lincoln Riley told me, he told his team that they have to remember that they're not playing their game right now. They had those turnovers that put them behind. And he also said that CeeDee Lamb wasn't able to do much throughout the week, so they weren't able to game plan some without him playing with the offense. The reason why they let him warm up is because he wanted to be with his team, but now he's out here in street clothes, guys.
Hurts hit as he throws the football. Hard hit. Ball flutters to the turf, and the Bears' pass rush continues to be a big story.
Yeah, and good coverage downfield, but, you know, this defensive line, we knew coming in that James Lynch had the ability to get there. And that time, Jalen Hurts hesitated just slightly, waiting for his receiver to break free, and it gave James Lynch enough time to apply that pressure and get his hand up there to knock that ball down.
Lynch is a guy who goes almost 300 pounds, plays with a ton of finesse in his game. Hurts, though, escapes. They left a big lane for him, and the quarterback again moves the sticks, first down across the 45.
Now, this is a good job of recognizing blitz up the middle, and then you're going to see a lot of man-to-man coverage across the board. Watch how Jalen Hurts recognizes that. He sees this man clear out, this man blitzing, so he's got the alley right there to be able to take off and get yards. Clears out. The last thing you want to do is leave Jalen Hurts a chance to pick up yards like that.
Hurts gets the ball out quickly, and the catch is made in the far side there by Morris. And they are in business again, threatening inside the Baylor 40.
They continue to work that slot to the right and to the left. This time, catch Baylor in man. So when Morris makes that catch, he turns the corner. There's nobody there. He's able to take off and get those first down yards.
Play action. Hurts banged around to the pocket, delivers across. Morris hit hard, makes the catch. It'll be another first down.
Give the offensive line a lot of credit there, because Baylor's been getting after Jalen Hurts. Watch the pressure come from the right. Brooks, the back, does a good job just getting in the way, and then the vision downfield as he's getting banged around by Hurts to eventually find an open receiver. But Kennedy Brooks, coming off that play action look, does just enough to give his quarterback enough time to throw that.
Brooks, first down handoff, trapped behind the line. And Hurts not used to being hit. He only sacked 10 times all season, been sacked 3 times tonight.
A different deal tonight. Phil Snow with his 3-3-5 is just saying, you know what, without C.D. Lamb, we're going to take our chances. We don't care. Until you make us pay for it, we're going to attack. Phil Snow, a veteran defensive coordinator, been all over the country. Of course, came down from Temple when Matt Rhule took this job, but he's blitzing his inside backers, his hybrid backers on the outside. We've seen Lynch and Williams coming, really turning up the heat on the line and on Jalen Hurts.
Play action again. Hurts takes off on second down. He eludes one tackle. Four of Proctors will take him to the 21. Houston stops him. It'll be 3rd and 3.
I mean, even when he's able to make one guy miss, you know, there's 2 or 3 more green jerseys. There's positive yards by Jalen Hurts. You see, again, they bring Lynch on the blitz. Now he's got some room. He makes Arnold miss, but there you go. There's the secondary. Able to keep him short of that first down. A good drive right now to start this second half by the Sooners. They need a touchdown here.
Hurts has run it 14 times tonight, more than the tailbacks combined. Looking to throw for it. Pressure. Flushed. Scans the field and flips it incomplete. Trying to fight back to the football there was Hazelwood. A flag is down near the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a hold on Oklahoma. Would have come back anyway. But how about the pressure again? We just talked about how they don't care. They're going to bring pressure with the blitz.
Now, do you take the penalty? It's going to be 4th and about 3. Do you back them up with the holding call?
By number 56 of the offense. The 10-yard penalty, and it's still 3rd down.
It's going to push him back and give him another down here.
Didn't want to.
I was with you.
They're going to go for it,
yeah,
clearly.
I thought with the way their defense been playing, I thought he might consider that. But he pushes him back and gives Lincoln Riley this offense another down. Who can win? Who can win against man-to-man? Who can get separation for their quarterback?
Well, they're searching for answers. They've spread the ball around to a variety of targets without the number one guy out there tonight, but have not really made a lot of dynamic Oklahoma-like plays downfield at all. 3rd and 13 now. Baskin motioning over to the right side. Bears standing up, coming after Hurts again, gets it out, and has a crosser wide open, and Rambo slips a tackle, center steps, still alive, knocked down hard, but it's 1st and goal, Oklahoma.
We wondered who would win. That's a mix-up with a crossing route right here. He comes across, nobody runs with him. They're man-to-man, but nobody stays with him. Shallow cross, Rambo, because he comes underneath, nobody, I thought Arnold might run with him, but he doesn't. So after he makes the catch, everybody else is a man-to-man. He's got nothing but real estate to pick up.
Oklahoma, 28-yard gain in that 3rd and 13. Brooks is the back on 1st and goal. He's got it. He's swarmed. He'll lose back to the 4. Bravion Roy, another tackle, got there quickly.
But Roy is having a big night. You know, they've been rotating him in and out to try trying to keep him fresh. But, man, watch the line of scrimmage here.
Down inside the five-yard line. Look at the push by the green jerseys led by Roy.
Dan, they are pinning their ears, attacking between those tackles. Makes it very tough. OU's going to have to get out wide. Based on that motion, he saw man-to-man. He checks for a man-to-man play.
Play clock at four. Brooks plows into heavy traffic. Gains about a yard. It'll be third down.
That is a grind with this defensive line. Roy, Lockhart, Lynch, linebackers Bernard, Williams coming downhill.
Look at about an offensive average, almost 7 yards per rushing play coming in, having to earn every inch tonight.
I'm surprised. I think Jalen Hurts, with his athletic ability out on the edge, give him a chance to run it or throw it.
And Hurts was looking to run, now tries to fire in the end zone. Caught, touchdown. Stockner, the tight end again, is becoming an unlikely touchdown scorer for this offense.
That is a great throw by Jalen Hurts, bringing Stockner back. Pressure again by Big 93, James Lynch. But as he rolls out here, he's got to get rid of the ball. And watch where he ends up locating and finding. He brings it back away from the defender, which forced Stockner to have to come back. That was respect to the Baylor defender in that right corner. So he brings it back a little more to the middle. And you're right, the freshman tight end once again capitalizes to finish off that drive.
Big rangy dude, 6'6", just 237. First two career touchdowns, and the Sooners trim the lead to 14.
Defense against Charlie Brewer in the second half.
Berkowitz drives a kickoff to the end zone. OU defense that allowed Baylor to score on each of them. Michael Hasty is the back. He's got the football. And he breaks free. Hasty, center step, loses it, ball is out. And Oklahoma finally has a takeaway. Pat Fields recovers the fumble. They're going crazy over there because the five-game takeaway drought is over. Parnell Motley knocked the ball out of Hasty's hands.
At first I was about to say, boy, they let up a huge run on their veterans, Kenneth Murray. Not real gap sound. They just let this play pop. Watch this thing open up right through the middle right here. Murray's got to make that play, right? Instead, he overruns it. Now they're in the open field. Now you got to count on a safety. They catch a break with Motley. The corner ends up ripping the ball out. Goes right into the hands of Fields. Bounces up right there. As you said, Chris, first one since late September. But they get the ball back to the offense.
Yeah, fumble recovery against Texas Tech, and nothing since. And ironically, Hasty wrapped up two hands on the ball just when Motley punched it out. So a big momentum shift early in the third quarter as the Sooners begin from their 45. Play action again. Hurts has plenty of time, as dumps it off to Brooks, who cannot get free, penned in on the sidelines for a very short game.
Now you got Baylor, who builds a 31-10 lead at halftime against the OU Sooners on national TV in this mid-stage. Sooners come right back. Start this second half, they get a touchdown, they get a turnover. I think it's imperative that Matt Rhule, Bill Snow, and his team continue to play with that aggressive mindset that they played with. They can't go into hold-on mode. They got to continue to do what they've done the entire game, and that's being aggressive.
Hurts on second down, looks to throw, fires near side, and the catch is made, holding on after a big hit is Morris. It's a first down.
You have to keep looking for receivers to make plays. Give Morris some credit here. We saw A.D. Miller earlier make a few catches on that back side. This time Hurts walks back to 84. And a good job, as you said, Chris, of holding on to that football. He got hit hard.
Brooks finds a little crease. Nice open field tackle by Chris Miller, but it's still a five-yard gain.
Oh, you got away with a hold that time. Robinson, 52, grabbed the hold of Blake Lynch, and the offensive referee just didn't see it. Watch two right here on the right side, right there. Just grabs a hold of him right in front of where the ball carrier was trying to go. But a no call.
Yeah, pump fake. It's a straight run, and he plows for another first down. Miller tackles him, but they're inside the 33.
Follows Hayes. Brown just kind of following to see Oklahoma run this play over the year. Just kind of quarterback counter where he follows the back and also the left guard. Outnumber the right side or the left side of that Baylor defense up front. It's the beauty of having a running quarterback, basically a tailback, with the skill set that Jalen Hurts has running the football.
First down again, plenty of time. Hurts escapes, and he'll be knocked down after another nice first down game by Terrell Bernard. Pretty one-dimensional, but it's tough to stop at the moment.
Yes, it is. Yeah, and that I think that was Phil Snow's biggest fear. You can draw things up to stop Jalen Hurts, but at the end of the day, what you can't predict is when he takes off. And you can have a plan, but your guy's got to go out and tackle him. That's tough to do against a quarterback that's 6'2", 220 pounds.
And Hurts has got it, trying to get the edge this time. Ducks down a yard short of the marker.
Been really impressed, Chris, with Jalen Hurts' attitude. I guess we shouldn't be shocked. I mean, this game has not gone the way they envisioned. He's been hit hard and hit often, and yet he keeps running this football, doesn't even blink. 17 carries. You have a feeling by the end of this game, he may carry 30 times.
What's the record high quarterback record?
I don't know. Modern Ed Holloway, Charles Thompson, I don't know who it is.
Brooks closes the ball, bouncing around, he got it back. Turnover averted, and it's a first down in the red zone. Very nearly, Bonta switching play for Baylor.
Yeah, the safety, Chris Miller, coming up. I think he knocked the ball loose. Remember, he is a physical safety three right here. Yep, got his hand on the ball. That's what knocked it loose. How fortunate is Oklahoma? They're looking, fighting, scratching, clawing to get to that football before those green jerseys jump off.
The bouncing ball went right through the hands of Jamison Houston in the corner. From the 17, Hurts took a brief look downfield, shakes a tackle, and darts forward. You got to get him on the ground, even if you know he's going to run. Even if you have men in the area, you got to tackle this big, strong dude.
Yeah, it's a lot easier said than done. Watch the right tackle. He's just trying to get downfield, trying to help out, trying to find somebody to pick up. He's got the running back there. Actually, a missed block there by Robinson, but that shows you what Hurts can do with his power to run out of that arm tackle.
There's a bear down. It's Miller on the far sideline. He was involved in the latest tackle with Hurts. He's had a bunch of collisions with the quarterback tonight. He's given away about 30 pounds in that matchup. We'll take a break. Brooks motions pass up the backfield. Yep. Quarterback takes off. You know it's coming. You can't stop it. It's first and goal.
Yep. Just gets behind those big offensive linemen. You know, the one thing about these Baylor linebackers, even though they have been incredibly aggressive tonight, they are undersized. And even if they're there, at 218 pounds, Jordan Williams, Small, Lynch, Bernard, you know, they're 218, 220-pound linebackers. Play with speed, not necessarily power.
This is why Jalen Hurts goes in the squat rack even after games.
Right.
Build that leg strength. Fires for the end zone. Tried to zip it high to Hazelwood. Incomplete. Houston in coverage. Second down.
They try to catch him off guard here. You're thinking again, they're going to run with Hurts. And instead, they try to get a one-on-one matchup. He tries to go high. You can see Hazelwood isn't the biggest. I mean, he's about 6'1". We tried to climb the ladder, but really never had a chance. Pretty good coverage out here as well.
Yeah, Miller leaping kind of took away the lane, didn't it? See if they go back to the quarterback run here on second down. Looking to throw again. Nope. It was just a fake. Loses the ball as he crosses the goal line. Baylor has recovered in the end zone. Did he break the plane? They're ruling it a fumble recovered by Lynch.
Yeah, Lynch knocked that ball loose before Jalen Hurts broke the plane. That ball is
play. He's not going to prevent him from getting to the end zone. Jalen Hurts is already by him. So what does he do? He just puts his right hand out to try to get to the ball, and he knocks it loose.
They're having a consultation. There was a flag at the end of the play. Here's another look.
Look at that right hand. He can't make the tackle, but he got his right hand on the ball. Ball's out well before he's even close to the end zone.
It'll be a third turnover by Hurts, a second fumble, and an enormous play by James Lynch. The big, hefty defensive end. Normally he's a pass rusher getting after quarterbacks, but reaches out, Kirk, and makes a play that could reverse momentum in this game.
What you love about that, kind of
the
symbolic.
The ruling on the field is that the ball was fumbled at the half-yard line into the end zone and recovered by the defense. That's a touchback. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct by number 54 for Oklahoma. It's a 15-yard penalty. And it's first down.
That is crazy. That is not the first clutch play he's made, that forced fumble. And now Brewer will be trapped behind the line by Ronnie Perkins. Here's the penalty after the play. Hayes there, shoving Bernard.
Probably could have been offsetting there as far as what was being said back and forth between the two players. But, Chris, I'll just say this, too, that I don't know about you, but if Oklahoma scores there and it's 31-24, they've controlled things in the second half. Wouldn't you have had that feeling? Baylor had to leave. Uh-oh.
Well, there would have been a serious uh-oh. Now, can the Bears offense get the rhythm back? Again, five straight scoring drives. They benefited from some good field position after the takeaways in the first half. But there's some urgency here because their defense is on seals.
And that play right there by Pat Fields, remember, he's 5'11", working up against some bigger receivers. That's the first time they've stopped that corner route. Baylor has hit that. They've been in sync. They've hit Mims on a lot of them. But that time, much better coverage by Fields, almost anticipating the route.
Lovett is the back. Sooners were showing some pre-snap pressure before Baylor paused to take a look. Play clock is winding down at 4. Brewer's got to hurry. Just gets it off. They come after him. It's a screen. Ducked down. And a nice open field play made to just slow down Lovett enough for the cavalry to arrive, and they stopped short of the marker.
Yeah, it was Parnell Motley, the corner, who jumped up and didn't quite make the tackle, but it got underneath the block by the lineman that was out in front, Keith. And by doing that, he actually forced Lovett to lose his balance and didn't let him pick up the momentum, and eventually he would be able to pick up the first down. Good effort there by the secondary, which has been the much maligned secondary over the last three games.
Sooner defense does its job. The tackle for loss on first down was crucial in that series. Power boots it away. Stoops will let it bounce, and it will roll dead down inside the 10. Inside of 3 minutes.
First today, 56-21, Penn State, a battle against Indiana. We got it done at home.
Hurts on first down, batted down at the line. Yeah, Penn State, an 18-play, 9-minute drive to bleed out the clock against Indiana. KJ Hamel leaving the game. His status is going to be a major concern for that game next week.
Yeah, Tom Allen doing a really good job. Once again, Jordan Williams, the linebacker, up in the air. Second time we've seen him time that up and knock the ball down.
Hurts keeps it on second down. Waited for the last second to pull the ball out from Brooks and picks up about 7.
Yeah, he's reading the linebacker flow there. Just trying to get a feel. It's a power read, meaning he can either give that to the back or he can pull it out, depending on how the linebackers flow. They're flowing outside with the back, and that's why he ended up pulling it out of there. Trying to cut underneath that right guard who was pulling.
Third and 3. The big play, potentially, for this Baylor defense to get off the field quickly here. They come after Hurts. It's picked up. He gets the ball out. And the catch is made, and the fingertips by Lee Morris. A nice throw at first down.
And a great throw that time by Jalen Hurts. Again, Phil Snow decided to bring that pressure. It means he got one-on-one. There's the linebackers. They give him enough time. They're closing in on him, but he sits in the pocket, puts it out there where Morris can get his hands up to make the play. And Morris, nice job of getting separation against 22 JT Woods.
defense execution. Wondered who would step up. CeeDee Lamb is out. It's a nice job by Morris.
Hurts now looking to throw on first down. Scanning will tuck it and takes another big hit, but picks up six on first down.
If there's no contest on who's the toughest guy, maybe when you talk about these quarterbacks, this guy's having this kind of year, this guy's having this kind of year. It's been talked about, it's well documented, his story, but watching him tonight, I mean, he's getting hit hard, and he's not flinching. He just keeps going back, keeps making plays, doesn't hesitate at all when it's his number to be called and run this football. And it's a design run or a new quarterback scramble.
20-second carry.
And he does it so calmly, you know, with his facial expressions.
They come after Hurts again. Delivers incomplete. And no flag in coverage there, trying to get the ball to Weiss.
Yeah, I think he got his right hand around Barnes in coverage. Watch him work around. Yeah, he grabbed it. Yep, he grabs. I'm surprised they didn't call the left hand to grab on the jersey. I think what they saw was maybe the right hand not interfering. He worked around the receiver. There's no question he was grabbing with that left hand, but on the jersey.
Baylor gets away with one. It's another chance to get off the field here. Final minute of the quarter. Third and five now. Pressure again. Hurts gets it out. Catch made by Weiss, who makes a man miss. Spinning free. Different Sooners stepping up with Lamb out. He got a first down of the 48.
He's got crossers here. Kind of a mesh concept. He's trying to look downfield. This, again, requires the offensive line to be able to do a good job of getting in time. Here's his receiver that's clearing. That mesh route causes some traffic for the defense, makes it tough to stay with your man and man-to-man. And Henry Black that time got caught.
Hurts takes off again. Lowers the shoulder and picks up eight on first down. Jordan Williams and the tackle, Kirk, they have run now 30 plays offensively in this third quarter. That has got to be wearing down an undersized Baylor defense.
They're trying to rotate to stay fresh. Up to 67 plays for the game. You know what? Jalen Hurts doing a good job. When they're blitzing those linebackers and safeties, he's recognizing either the ball out or take off and run for the scramble.
Last play of the quarter. Completion again. And this is Morris down to the 30. 31 offensive plays. The Bears ran, I believe, four off the top of my head as Oklahoma cuts the lead to 14 and is threatening as we begin the final quarter here in Waco. Back after this message and a word from your local ABC. Harvest Moon in Waco. Oklahoma cut the lead from 21 to 14, but you will not find a more lopsided quarter of college football in those three categories. 31 to 4 in the plays. Baylor gained 38 yards in those four plays. Remember, they had the turnover. So Oklahoma begins the final quarter down 14, but on the Baylor 30, after that kind of punishing possession, you wonder what the Bears defense has left, Kirk, for the fourth quarter here. Hurts out of a two-back look, flips it to Stevenson. He gets a block from Morris on the edge and picks up five more on first down.
Nice safe throw there on first and 10. Gets the ball out onto the perimeter and into the hands of a playmaker in Stevenson at 236 pounds and get their tempo going. We wondered who would step up. One of the guys is Lee Morris, and even on this drive, 84, he's in the slot to the left. Really made some plays tonight with Lamb out.
Stevenson, he's a big physical dude trying to hammer downhill. They stop him a couple yards short, but these guys in green, they waited a long time to have this big stage to seize this moment. It was a party in here in the second quarter. Now a whole bunch of dudes in that side of the ball having to dig very deep here.
And Phil Snow continues trying to rotate, trying to stay fresh.
They come off the edge with pressure. Stevenson hit, and he'll be stopped short just by McVay. It'll be fourth down and about a yard.
Boy, that is a great play, Chris. It just does not hesitate, kind of waits, looks to see where he needs to fire. Hadn't been playing a lot, but you'll see 42 just get in there, and once he sees that he's free to make that play, he just lowers his shoulder to keep him short of that first down. Waits.
I think they gave him a generous spot, based on where he appeared to be down there. Baylor's going to spend a timeout on defense. That seems like a wise move. Rule asking his guys to suck it up and get a stop. Make the 20. To keep alive another long drive. Hurts fights forward. The spot would have made the difference. We'll show you the play. It's a first down inside the 20. They got the push. They got the first down. But that call just, I mean, Dave Katai is up there saying that because not of all the first down gain, they're reluctant to use the technology. That just is ludicrous to me.
Especially in a game like this where that's every yard counts. By the way, they're reviewing this
on the field of the first half. Down is confirmed. First down.
They've had to rotate more in this second half just because of the amount of plays they've defended. Oklahoma up to 72. We have 13 minutes to go in this game. I mean, they're going to be, I think, up in the 90s by the time we're done.
So Hurts and Brooks figure just to keep rounding and pounding against this Baylor defense. It's a first down throw instead. And the catch is made by Weiss, who spins it free and is going to score. And Oklahoma cutting the lead to just one score as the freshman from Allen scores for just the second time this season.
Here come the Sooners. Look at a wink of the eye here by Jalen Hurts. Lincoln Riley told us this week on our call, it's a matter of time to these younger freshmen start to make plays in the second half of this season. Progressive Highline gives us the most. But I'm just telling you, these young receivers, you can see why they're so excited about what these guys can do.
A 90-yard, 13-play drive took just a second, under 5 minutes. And now, with 12:58 to play, it is a one-score game. And this Baylor offense, Kirk, has barely been on the field since the second quarter. It's going to have to get its rhythm back because Theo Weiss spins free. And the Sooners are right back in it. Discover some rhythm. They're going to have to give a rest to this tired defense because the Sooners have just been pulverizing them ever since halftime. Fleeks. Stop at the 22. The All-State bus. It was a party here in the second quarter, but it is tense now. The lead is just 7. Oklahoma's defense has stepped up lately, and Baylor's offense needs to get back to, as he said, letting it rip, Matt Rule. So that was the plan coming into the game, and they did.
Yeah, let it rip when you have your chances with the football. Look at the plays in the second half. Oklahoma 36-5. Look at the time of possession. Total yards. That's what's gotten Lincoln Riley and his team back into this football game. And now it's up to Charlie Brewer and this offense to answer.
And Brewer, who was such an effective runner in the first half, is going to be swallowed up by Ronnie Perkins, and that loss will make it 3rd and long.
Well, they did a nice job here, this time taking away that quarterback draw. Adjustments, because in the first half, this is a play that was effective. This time, getting off of blocks. Perkins does a nice job of cleaning it up, but the linebacker in the middle there took it away. Nowhere for Brewer to take off on a play that was very successful in the first half.
Can he make a play with his arm to move the sticks on 3rd and 9? Nice time from the pocket, delivers a long throw, and it's dropped. Bobbling the ball was Tyquan Thornton, had a chance to pick up a crucial first down, could not hold on. It's another 3 and out.
They did everything right except catch the ball. Great route, turns the defender around, just doesn't secure it for the first down. Ball perfectly thrown, just hold on to it right there, Thornton. And instead, they do not convert. And OU's going to get the ball back again.
Kirk, you think about when they have had the ball here. Hasty, the big run, but the fumble. Thornton with that crucial drop. And Oklahoma's sideline energized and fired up. And Stoops is the man who's going to try to field this ball, which bounces by him. He did not touch it, and it'll be finally down at the 22. Three turnovers by Jalen Hurts, Kirk, but a ton of toughness.
That's what he's talked about, how this team has confidence to be able to come back. Even with CeeDee Lamb out, their quarterback has made plays throwing and running and also just being able to dissect man-to-man, making a throw here to Lee Morris, who has six catches all for first downs. Here, run-pass option. He sees that he's got a route open on the outside, gets it to his playmaker, Weiss, who makes a few people miss and gets into the end zone. And just like that, Sooners down seven with 11:26 to go and all the momentum.
It was 28-3 in the second quarter. The touchdown they got to cut into the lead on a defensive hold that prolonged the drive. But now, another touchdown they can get dead even from the 23. Pass slipped to Rambo in the flat, and he weaves his way for about a 10-yard gain.
Nice catch again. They've gone to that to start drives. Quick pass is out to the edge, out of the perimeter, whether it's been dumping it out to Stevenson or Brooks, one of the backs. This time they give it out to Rambo. And the reason that's important is kind of a jump start to the drive. Quick, easy throw. Now they get the tempo going.
And this Baylor defense, which has been on the field almost nonstop since halftime, has to find the energy to tackle some very physical players. There's a 2-yard gain. Roy tackles Brooks.
Watches Oklahoma as they go tempo. Are they substituting? Are they giving Baylor a chance to rotate themselves with Oklahoma's offense to try to get fresh bodies in there? They've done a pretty throughout this game the best that they can, but it's taking a toll, you can tell, especially on the defensive lineman in the middle, Roy.
Play action, Hurts flips the ball off underhanded forward. Lynch was there. They're going to rule the...
I think he was throwing it to Willis, 81, and he had a couple of different guys there. How about the pressure here? See, right here, I think he's just trying to get it. Just dump it there. He's also got 26 Brooks. He's going to 81 that time. Brayden Willis.
Interesting decision. Got away with the incompletion. Makes it 3rd and 8. Crowd just imploring this Baylor defense to get a stop. Hurts in a three-man rush, has plenty of time. Brooks makes a man miss, and they move the sticks again. An open field tackle missed, and the running back makes a play.
What did they tell us in the meeting? Biggest thing they've got to do is tackle in the open field. Here's an opportunity coming in with a lot of speed with Blake Lynch, but unable to make that play.
And now Hurts from the pocket looks to launch it downfield, dumps it off to Brooks, who is stopped in Baylor territory after a 5-yard gain.
You know, Blake Lynch has been making most of those plays all night, but it's a sign of what fatigue can do to you when you get into that fourth quarter. It's like a boxer gets into that 11th or 12th round. It's a very, very different game right now for this defense.
There's a flag. He gave the fake clap, but it wasn't the Bears who flinched. It was the offensive line.
It's a 5-yard penalty.
Tyrese Robinson moving back to 2nd and 10 now.
What I love about Jalen Hurts is through adversity, his facial expressions rarely change.
Sure doesn't.
You know, he fumbled the ball at the 1-yard line. He's thrown touchdown passes. You get the same look on his face for 4 quarters.
As a blocker, Brooks leads in, Hurts spun down a yard short of the marker at the 45.
Again, on this quarterback draw, it's kind of a read. He's waiting to see if he can get the ball out or if he's going to take off. Just reading those linebackers to see what kind of depth they get. They get deep enough, he's going to take it, follow the back, follow the guard, Hayes, and he gets very, very positive yards there.
Some of the last 4 Oklahoma drives, at least 10 plays. Last time they had it was a 90-yard march. They substituted, which gives Baylor the chance to bring in some fresh bodies in that front. 3rd and 1 yard. Brooks, first down, makes a cut, wrestled down at the 35, and the drive continues.
Boy, nice cut. Nice job in the middle of that offensive line, opening things up. Humphreys had a big challenge tonight, but he keeps battling in there. That time Hayes helps him out. Nice block as well by Stevenson.
down now, 80 for Oklahoma, 43 for Baylor, just 7 in the second half so far for the Bears. Play action, slant, catch made by Hazelwood, first and 10 inside the 20.
Now there's freshman. CeeDee Lamb is down. Who's going to step up? How about the freshman Hazelwood? Soft coverage that time against Houston. Time to throw because they're mixing run with pass. Sits back there, waits for his man to break free, and puts a dime out there.
Brooks to the far and left of the formation. Empty backfield on first down. Play clock at 4. Hurts zips it far side against a cushion. Miller makes a catch, and the veteran knocked out at the 11.
You saw him see empty. He looks at coverage. He makes the check. The reason he went to that is because you have one defensive back, and you've got two receivers out here. They can't cover both. So he sees that. That's that experience again that you get with Jalen Hurts, recognizing that. Didn't look over the sidelines for help. He saw that on his own, saw a two-on-one situation back into the boundary and capitalizes on some good yards.
Two-back look on second and 2. Handoff, Brooks, knocked down. You're talking about a team without its playmaker that has had to completely change its personality. They've gone from lightning strike downfield throws to just a grinding old-school offense here.
Think about their drives in the second half. We've seen a 14-play drive. We've seen, that was a touchdown, a 12-play drive, 11-play where he fumbled it to 1 yard line, 13-play drive for a touchdown. This is play 11 right here.
Usually they're a Ferrari. This is just a Mack truck in first gear, not banging forward, but
to mention you're down 31-10, right?
Yep.
And there isn't a sense of panic. Keep in mind, when you watch Jalen Hurts, think of the games he's played in as he was a freshman. Got all the way to a national championship, right, against Clemson.
Yep.
Played in the Iron Bowl against Auburn. He's been in the SEC championship. Did that his sophomore year. I mean, this is a high-pressure game, but nothing that he hasn't been through throughout his career.
Still got it. Flips it in the flat. Catch made by Stevenson. Knocked out just short of the pylon. He's third down.
I thought he was going to be able to turn the corner with that speed and dive to that pylon. Just not quite able to get there. But again, a positive play here. Watch, he's got 236 pounds trying to get to that corner, but Baylor's speed keeps him from getting there.
13th play of this marathon drive.
86th overall.
Hurts rolls, looks for the end zone. Touchdown wide open is Braden Willis. Oklahoma, a PAT away from tying the football game.
Safety's eyes got affected here. Gonna have a tight end work outside, work out here. Watch this safety and this safety. Watch their eyes get caught up and Jalen Hurts and jet motion. Nobody picks up the tight end sliding out into the back of that end zone for another touchdown and an extra point away from tying it.
Another long march. 77 yards. 6 minutes on the clock. A 25-point deficit has been erased.
Because of sacks, he's now negative in the second half.
Hasty. And the kickoff return, knocked out at the 22. And Baylor becoming off. Got to find a way in this offense to make plays. The first down throw, they take it downfield. Shot to Mims, who was just tackled by Nelmont, who was going to get beat and just grabbed him.
I love this call because you go right back to your playmakers that were making plays in the first half and believe in them. If they're going to leave your talented receiver Mims one-on-one against Motley, you got to try to beat him. You got to try to take that.
By number 11 of the defense.
If you don't execute it, then you get the pass interference call. That's what they did.
Mims is a guy that really hurt the Sooners. He's been their big receiver all year long. Couple of touchdown receptions. Ball moved to the 37 on the penalty. Brewer has been a clutch quarterback his whole life. both in high school and here at Baylor. He's been a master in tight games in the fourth quarter. With a handoff to Ebner, back there getting back healthy to hope he can make some big plays tonight, but he's been hemmed in, Murray and Perkins on the stop.
Yeah, Murray getting downhill in a hurry, but also Turner Yell, the safety, working down. They just overload the box there. There's nowhere to run with the ball. Murray's here, safety late breaking down. Nobody picks him up, and I don't know where you can go if you're Ebner. Nice job there by late movement for this defense by Alex Brent.
Mims on the right side. Again, it's Motley in coverage. Brewer looking the other direction, now tries to spin free, chased by Perkins, looking for a man, fires from the sideline, it's incomplete. Trying to fight back to the football there with Sneed, but it'll be third and 11, Kirk.
Yeah, when they need pass rush, you know, they've been blitzing at times with Murray. I'll tell you, Ronnie Perkins has been able to get in there, and if he can get his hands on Brewer, at least he's forcing him to get out of the pocket. That's what he did there.
This Baylor offense, serious urgency. You're going to give the ball back to Hurts in tie game with a fatigue defense. You will, unless you can make 11 yards here. Brewer has time. Looks for Mims down the sideline. Just over his outstretched hands. They had two men covering him, and it's fourth down.
And they did their scouting report. They looked at the film. They know when the game's on the line that Brewer's going to look that way and actually backed off. Little stutter and go. Motley backs off. He also, as you said, Chris, had Pat Fields to safety over top. But that play never had a chance. Motley, instead of being uptight and press man, backed off right as the ball was snapped.
Isaac Power, punt to Snoops. Stoops just barely avoided a mistake the last time. He got a hand near that rugby punt, didn't touch it. And they have roughed the punter. Oh, my goodness. Oklahoma with a mental mistake as they came after Isaac Power. Now, only the personal foul resulted a first down. It's fourth and 11, remember.
I mean, it looks like he's running into the punter. There's some pretty good acting by the punter. I don't think he
was. Not roughing, yeah. I shouldn't have said roughed. He did get contacted. But it's only the five-yard variety.
Yeah.
Ran into the extended leg.
Power did his best to go down. But, yeah, it's just running in to the punter.
Running into the kicker by the defense. He hit the kicking leg. It's a five-yard penalty, and it's fourth down.
Rule asking for some clarification. If you can hit the extended leg, and that's usually just a five-yard penalty. If you hit the plant leg or knock him down, it's a personal foul.
Well, I think Matt Rule, I think they're trying to figure out if he declined it, or can you push him back 5 yards at the spot?
It'd be fourth and six if they accept the penalty, and they'd repunt it, you would presume. He's buying some time for a tire defense, perhaps, which you have to think is a strong move.
Yeah, he's going to wave it off.
Decline. It's first down.
This defensive team has been outstanding. The number one scoring defense in the Big 12. They got off to a great start tonight, but they have had no answer for the power running Jalen Hurts and some clutch passes to very unheralded receivers who've stepped up with Lamb out tonight.
Yeah, they sure have. Hurts has again played incredibly well. 25 carries tonight. He's 28-39. We've seen Morris and Rambo. We've seen the young freshmen step up and make a few plays here late with Weeks and Hazelwood.
The Baylor team that's won two multiple overtime games. If you ask this crowd right now, I think they'd take overtime. They'd like their chances in OT because they have not been able to stop Hurts in this offense. They come after Jalen on first down, and they sacked him. It's about a four-yard loss. Jordan Williams has just been playing sick tonight. Makes a play.
Here's the key right here with late movement. They're able to get pressure. See how he stunts late, catches the offensive line off guard, and the left guard, left tackle occupied by a couple defenders, but the middle linebacker there, Bernard, timed that up perfectly.
fourth sack for Baylor. Oklahoma had only given up 10 all year. On second and long, Brooks on the edge. Slips a tackle and is in the clear. Kennedy Brooks rolling into Baylor territory to the 45.
This power read. Nice job by Hurts reading this, getting him outside. Now you need receivers to block. They do their job, man. All three of them pick up nice blocks downfield. So instead of an 8 to 10 yard gain, he's able to pick up 20 or 30.
It's a 32-yard run. And Oklahoma, after trailing 25, threatening now to take the lead. Hurts, again, escapes and has room and runs straight north and south and slides for a first down at the 34.
But you blitz one linebacker and the other one gets caught up in man coverage. Here's the blitz, and watch him in coverage. He puts his back to Jalen Hurts. You get one blitz. Now you've got nobody left, right? There's nobody in the middle of the field. If you don't get to him, you're in trouble. And that's exactly what happened. You got one defender that's occupied looking at coverage, another one that blitzed and ends up missing. And now you got a lot of room for him to take off and get yards.
Play action, Hurts back, pedals, fires down the middle in the traffic, and it's incomplete. Tejada was in coverage. Theo Weiss, the freshman who caught the touchdown earlier, was the intended receiver.
One-on-one. One-on-one late in the game. You've defended 90 snaps. You're out there on an island. Who's going to win that matchup? Lincoln Riley, who's been doing a lot with Jalen Hurts' legs and a lot of quick throws, tries to take advantage of a shot downfield. The Bears are there to defend it.
Big cushions for these Oklahoma receivers. And Hurts flips it over the middle. Catch made in traffic by Morris, who's going to have first down yardage at the 21.
Nice job of just sitting down. They've been mixing up man and zone. Morris does a nice job of feeling that soft spot in the zone coverage and just settles down in there. They did play action to affect the eyes of the linebackers. And then Jalen Hurts is able to put that ball right where he needed to for Morris.
Clock approaching the final 2 minutes. Low snap, gets by Hurts, scoops it up. Desperation heave out of bounds. Almost a disastrous, massive loss. Hurts has to retreat and keeps calm under.
That's what I was going to say, is instead of just falling on it, the ball, bad snap. Okay, now you got to try to get it, pick it up, and then he picks it up. Now he knows he's outside of the pocket. Now I just got to get it past the line of scrimmage. Really good play to save a lot of yards in a critical moment in this game with 2:01 left.
Absolutely. If he falls on that ball, they're out of field goal range for the moment. It's second and a mile.
Great play.
Brooks. Hard hitting run. Bangs forward for about four. It'll be third down. Williams and Bernard combining on the tackle. Third down play. Bears spend a timeout. Final 2 minutes. Tied up. Tries to take their first lead since it was 3-0 early.
A lot of these critical third downs, he's been able to find Lee Morris to his right spot.
Looking that direction, ball pitched off underneath to Rambo. He has stopped short. Fourth down coming up from the 14.
Matt Rhule right away jumps out onto the field, uses that last timeout as OU is going to face a fourth down.
So, field goal team figures to come out to give the Sooners a lead after this break. Gabe Berkich, the freshman, hasn't missed this season. Hasn't had to kick too many pressure field goals, though. And Oklahoma moving it 59 yards and 8 plays. Baylor this time stops him short of the end zone. Now for the first time since it was 3-0, Oklahoma wants down 28-3, tries to go up by 3. This from 31 yards for the lead.
Baylor, an excellent kick block team. They blocked five kicks this season. A couple of field goals, PAT, a punt. It's a big part of their MO.
Prior to the snap, delay of game.
They go use, wondering if they got a timeout. I saw Lincoln Riley, as the clock was going down, he jumped to the official to try to get it.
Correction. Prior to the snap and prior to the clock expiring, Oklahoma called a timeout.
We'll take a very quick break. Berkich is known for getting the ball off the ground. Good lift initially in the kick, which makes it tough to block. But again, Baylor has been very good at this. So after a timeout, 31 yards for the lead. No problem for the freshman. Still perfect on the season. And Oklahoma is in front. And now Charlie Brewer is going to have to try to lead yet another come-from-behind drive. This was routine for the young guy. Brewer has made a specialty of this five times in his career, had come-from-behind drives in the fourth quarter. That doesn't count two other drives when he got him down and they got to overtime and won the game. Jalen, I'm not going to look, but it's no problem.
For the kicker we have, I'm confident that it's going to be good. Matt Rule's looking for Charlie Brewer to say, hey, we've been here, as you said, Chris, and been here, done this. It's time to go down and lead your team to either a game-tying field goal or let's try to win it. Remember, they're out of timeouts.
But it's a different feel because things were so easy for this offense. They were benefiting from takeaways, great field position. They were scoring at will against Oklahoma. Haven't had the football hardly at all after halftime. So you're asking him to come in pretty cold. And they had a couple of nervous-looking mistakes in the second half on offense as well. A fumble and a drop. And what would have been a drive-extending catch. Chick Mims has been the weapon. He's caught a couple of touchdowns. He's off to the left. Brewer's looking that way to give him a little cushion. And he will fight and stretch for about an 8-yard gain.
Remember, out of bounds in first downs, the only way the clock will stop. Charlie Brewer's worked on this every week in practice. Good against good, and now you got to execute against the OU defense.
He's been doing this since he was a middle school quarterback. In traffic, knocked down. Perkins got him, and the clock will continue to roll on the sack.
Yeah, this is where the offensive line, the receivers, you still have to maintain your poise, even though that clock is working down. It's a big third down here. He's got to find that matchup that he likes. Wouldn't be surprised if he goes back to Mims at the bottom.
On third down, he does look to that left side, but it's Sneed making the catch, and they have a first down.
Soft coverage allows him to get to the outside and not only picks up a first down, but obviously getting out of bounds stops that clock.
John Mayers, the kicker, made a 51-yarder at the end of regulation to force overtime, but that's about the extent of his range. They've got to get the ball near the Oklahoma 32-yard line. Mims, still alive on the catch, makes a move and stopped at the 40.
Very surprised that Alex Branch and OU in such soft coverage. Mims limping off, their go-to man. Such soft cushion against all four of the receivers, giving them the easy release off the line of scrimmage.
Clock winning again inside of 40 seconds as Brewer from the pocket looks across the middle, almost intercepted. Had it in the hands and dropped it. Nick Benito, the linebacker, could have sealed it right there.
But Benito's been rushing as a defensive end. I think he surprises Brewer by, instead of rushing, he just kind of sinks in coverage. And he throws it right to him. Completely catches Brewer off guard with a changeup. Instead of 35 rushing the quarterback, kind of a zone pressure where he settles back in coverage.
Brewer almost bobbled the snap. Now fires, and this one is intercepted. Given a second chance, Benito makes the pick, and a takeaway of all things is going to seal a massive comeback victory for Oklahoma. Five games than a takeaway. They had two enormous takeaways in the second half. Benito sprints down to the corner with the Sooner fans. We're going to celebrate a sweet comeback from 25 down.
I just talked about how he's been rushing Benito all game long. Lincoln Riley fired up. They do it again. He's right here. Instead again of pressuring, this time he's just going to settle back the right place at the right time. Gets right into that throwing lane. Those long arms, he's able to extend out and come up with that interception. Watch him reach out to make that play. Back-to-back plays where Brewer makes mental errors, doesn't recognize the rushing linebacker settling in coverage, throws it right to him twice, and he picks off the second one.
And a quarterback who in his career here has been so cool and calm under pressure makes the mistake. There'll be no perfect season for Baylor and Oklahoma, which looked to be in deep, deep trouble. Down 25 without CeeDee Lamb tonight. They basically reinvented their offense from a quick strike to grind it out, and Jalen Hurts' toughness was on display. He ran it 27 times tonight for 114.
Great job by Jalen Hurts maintaining his composure by this entire OU team to come back and win. And just say this real quick, Baylor's got Texas next week. They got to win that game to try to get a rematch against OU in the Big 12 championship.
It's a great point. You'll have to dig very deep. The biggest comeback victory in the long and illustrious history of Oklahoma football. They come from 25 down to win it without their playmaker. Maria?
I got you, Chris. All right, Jalen, 25 points down. That's how far you had to dig out of the hole. What was going through your mind when you came back out at halftime and it seems like the offense completely changed?
All the hard work with this team right here, coming together and finding a way to get the victory. I put us in a horrible situation and we found a way to come back. I love it.
What does it mean to you to be able to make that comeback? Because you had to make some very physical plays throughout that second half.
I think that shows the heart of this team, the courage, the character that we have, the ability to overcome adversity. We overcame adversity, and you know, you remember for what you do in November. So it's a big-time win today.
I saw you several times just talking to your offense, even walking over and touching the defense. What was the message that you had on the sideline?
You know, you can never get too high, never get too low. I know I made some critical mistakes, and I know that those guys are always watching me, so I want to try and set the right example for them so that there's always an opportunity, there's always hope to get it done, and we got it done today.
All right, coming into this game, you didn't have the playmaker you're so used to seeing, and that's CeeDee Lamb. What did you have to do to overcome not having him on the sideline with you?
Did this without CeeDee Lamb. A 25, however many point comeback without CeeDee Lamb. That speaks for itself.
All right, where do you guys take this win moving forward? What does this momentum teach you?
It'll be 1-0 this week. Got another opportunity. We're going to enjoy it for 24 hours, and we're going to get ready for TCU.
All right, thanks, Jalen.
TCU is next, followed by the Bedlam game in Stillwater. The Sooners seem headed for the conference championship game, and Hurts, as you pointed out, championship moments have been a part of his life at Alabama, and certainly continue here. I mean, that is just a remarkable gutsy effort.
I really can't say enough about him and his leadership, his composure, the poise that he played with. He can let go now a little bit and go celebrate with Lincoln Riley and this team. But 30 of 43 for 297, four touchdown passes, carried it 27 times for 114 yards.
Threw it for 297 after halftime, complete dominance by Oklahoma. Baylor was only able to run 16 plays. They had two turnovers. They had a crucial drop, which ended a drive. Matt Rhule's team, they have come late years. This one will sting. And we'll sing the old Baylor Lions song as they always do, and they will have to try to regroup to earn a rematch, as you said, against Texas.
You know, in the offseason, you work out, you look for that fourth quarter edge that every team looks for these moments when you find yourself down 21 on the road and you got to fight back without your best player in CeeDee Lamb and find a way to get it done. And Sooners deserve all the credit, man. Did not blink at all and battled back to win this game.
You've seen the biggest comeback in Oklahoma football history. 34-31. We're down to just three unbeatens in college football as Minnesota and Baylor have fallen today. These just LSU, Ohio State, and Clemson. And the playoff plot thickens. We've enjoyed it from Waco. Tonight's game produced by Bill Bunnell, directed by Derek Mobley. We salute Iron Tire, excellent crew here. Four wrap-up shows coming up next with Cassidy Hubbard.